We all know the book of Psalms, chapter 91. It's very, very common. All over the world, people recite these Psalms, and they kind of give a sense of protection. I know of people back in Africa who will listen to this psalm, or they will read it at night before going to sleep, and they feel that it kind of gives them some kind of cover and protection. I must confess, this is one psalm that has really blessed me. It shows the faithfulness, the unfailing faithfulness of God. And it reveals the power working in the saints, those who follow on to know the Lord. I tell you, I marvel when I see the manifold wisdom at work in this psalm. Praise God. I feel personally that the psalmist, the one who wrote this psalm, must have probably looked deeply into the tabernacle or into the temple of God, and he must have meditated on that awesome presence of God that was in the holies of holies. By now we know that Israel's protection, Israel's fame, Israel's sustenance, Israel's power was all lodged in that small, tiny powerhouse called the Holies of Holies in the midst of the temple. Praise God. So I can imagine the psalmist, the one who wrote Psalm 91, meditating. See, looking, you know, with the eyes of the Spirit into the tabernacle. See, I can imagine him meditating on the ark of God. The ark of God had two cherubims that were attached to the mercy seat, which was like a lid over the tabernacle of God. So these two cherubims, these angel-like structures of pure gold, attached in one piece to the mercy seat, were sculpted in a way that they kind of looked down. They looked down over the ark of God that was in the midst of the holies of holies. And their wings were spread out over the ark, said, as if they were watching, they watch over the ark. And their wings and feathers cover the ark of God. See it. Normally, the Bible records that when Moses would enter into the holies of holies, he will, you know, normally see God appear as a glorious, illuminous light or cloud underneath, in the midst of those cherubims, underneath the wings of the cherubims. That was the glory of God. That was Israel's source of victory. See, that was the power that sustained them in the wilderness, the power that gave them manna, waters, gushing out of rocks and streams, gushing out of dry places. See, that was the same power that sustained them all those years that they were in the wilderness. Praise God. And God is saying today that that power is still present, but people have to recognize the mystery of that presence, the mystery of the secret place of the Most High God. Because this secret It's what will give you the victory and the power throughout all eternity. Hallelujah. Today we have access by the Spirit into the holies of holies. We have access to that glory cloud that was underneath the wings of the cherubim. We have access into that divine ark of God. Because we know by now that those things that were made manifest through the ark of God are simply allegories of things to come. Praise God. God in his wisdom was trying to, you know, give us an insight into the things of the Spirit. Hallelujah. You know, minding how low man had descended, God has, you know, brought forth that structure to begin to teach us basic truths that we have forgotten. Hallelujah. Now the tabernacle is one thing that really blessed me. That was one thing that really gave me faith and understanding of the glory that is within man. Because individually, every man is a tabernacle. Individually and corporately, we all are a tabernacle. Praise God. It doesn't matter your condition. It doesn't matter what you are experiencing in the natural. It doesn't matter what the outer body might say. It doesn't matter what your finances might say. One thing is certain, and that is you are God's temple. You are God's tabernacle. The glory of God dwells in you. Praise God. And Christ was, you know, revealed from heaven to unveil this mystery to us. Hallelujah. That is why Paul asks, don't you know that you are the tabernacle of God? Of course, Jesus Christ came with this revelation first. Jesus Christ came and said, destroy that temple and I'll raise it up in 3 days. He was referring to his own self because he got the secret that his own body was the temple of God. Jesus was the first man recorded that got the mystery, the secret of his own self being the temple of God, the embodiment of the incorruptible and invisible God. Hallelujah. Before then, man had always looked outwardly for solace, outwardly for some kind of cover and protection. But Jesus knew the secret of the indwelling God and he walked in this mystery. In reality, Jesus walked in the secret place of the Most High. Jesus Christ knew that secret place, that throne room of power, that powerhouse within him, and he walked in it. And that was what sustained him, glorified him, and lifted him up above all his enemies. Oh God. Years later, Paul came on the scene. Don't you know that you are the temple of God? Praise God. Don't you know that you are the temple of God? See, if we do not know this, we are ignorant. If we do not know this, it is like a veil, a blanket, is over our faces. Praise God. But thank God he is here to destroy that veil, so that we can walk in the totality of life and security. Praise God. Security comes for those who dwell in the secret place of the Most High, underneath the shadow of the Almighty. Praise God. We must get the secret of what Psalm 91 is talking about. The secret place of the Most High God. The secret place of the Almighty. Hallelujah. He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High God. That is our calling today. The gospel and the mystery of Christ is like a key giving us entrance into this secret place of God. Hallelujah. So that we can dwell there. so that we can walk in the Almighty, have our being in the Almighty. Oh, praise God, hallelujah. Those who find the secrets of this mystery of Christ within them, because in reality, Christ within, walking in the consciousness, in the awareness of the Christ within you, the light personality within you, is the dwelling of the Most High God. That is the secret place of God within every man. But God wants you and I to awaken to this reality. Praise God. Let's go further. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom will I trust. Surely He will deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feather, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor by of the arrows that fly by day. For the pestilence that walketh in darkness, or the destruction that wasted at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at their side, and 10,000 at their right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with an eye shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Praise God. Behold, thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. Praise God. Hallelujah. It is those who rediscover the mystery of the Christ within. Those who walk in the consciousness of the light personality that they are in the secret place of the Most High God. Hallelujah. They are in the secret place under the shadow of the Almighty. This is the most elevated consciousness of pure light that God wants His sons to awaken back into. Praise God. In this consciousness, there is nothing like death. In this consciousness, there is nothing like fear. In this consciousness, there is nothing like lack or poverty consciousness. Because man walks in the Almighty God. Man realizes the mystery of his life that is hidden God. See, Paul talks about our life being hid in Christ in God. That is the consciousness. That is the consciousness of those who are waking to the voice of the Spirit in this hour. Praise God. That is what the gospel is all about. It's telling you to awake. Awake that you are sleeping. If you are sleeping, there is still a veil over your comprehension. See, if you are sleeping, you are still barred from that holiest place, that secret place of God, that place that the eyes have not seen. See, that dimension where men, the eagles, the vultures, have no idea of. It's a place hidden from all carnality. But it's only those who recognize truth and ascend on the wings of truth. Those who let go of the lie to lay hold on immortality and life. That immortality and life is Christ in you. Praise God. Hallelujah. This is the consciousness God is calling His sons into. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ says, in that day you shall know that you are in me and I am in you, and you are in the Father and the Father in me. Praise God. This is the secret place of the Most High. This is the consciousness that we are being awakened into. See, the reality that we are in the living God, that we are integrated in the glory of God. Apparently, the glory of God normally appeared as a cloud underneath, you know, the wings of those cherubims, you see, that hovered over the ark of God in the holies of holies. And Paul, in his letter to the Thessalonians, says, we shall be caught up to meet the Lord where? In the air, in the clouds. We meet the Lord in a cloud. Now that cloud is that cloud that was in that secret place, that compartment that was hidden from all men. Praise God. We are being called to ascend. This is what resurrection is. Resurrection is all about awakening back into that consciousness of the Christ. Let this mind be in you. Let this consciousness be in you, which was in Christ. See it, which realizes its oneness with God, which works with the mind of God. Put on the mind of Christ. Oh, hallelujah. Let go of your mind and put on that mind of Christ, that consciousness of Christ, and begin to see things from God's perspective. See, that is your covering throughout all eternity. That is the power of the ages to come. That is the thing that will keep you and clothe you and exalt you and, you know, throughout all eternity. That is the consciousness that will never fade away. Praise God. Thousands shall fall by your left, thousands by your right. He talks about the destruction and the wasting of everything corrupt, of flesh and blood. But it shall not come near thy dwelling place. See it. It shall not touch you. See it. It shall be far away. Destruction shall be far away because you dwell in the light as he is in the light. Hallelujah. This is the message that God was trying to give us when Noah walked out his salvation and entered into the ark. Noah discovered that door. Noah discovered the secret place of the Most High God. Noah entered into Christ consciousness. Noah's life was hid in the secret place of the Most High God, in the dwelling of the Almighty. See, and that was what preserved Noah. That was what exalted Noah. That was what transported Noah into the ages to come. We're speaking here in allegories. Praise God. Those of you who have not followed my messages, go back and listen to the messages on Noah. You will discover that the message on Noah are messages that are spiritually discerned. Praise God. Noah entered into Christ consciousness, the dwelling place of the Most High. See, Noah was in the resurrection as that boat was being lifted up, and it was preserved and taken up to that high elevated place. Praise God, that we know the high elevated place today is God's kingdom, is the new Jerusalem, is God's world, God's realm. That is the dimension of singing and joy. It's the dimension of all power. Praise God. It is the place of the great king. And there's only one king. And that queen king inhabits that place of God. And that is we who ascend in that same consciousness. For we all sit on that throne in one. For we are one. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Thousands shall fall by your left and by your right. It shall not come near you. See it. Corruption shall not feed on you. The worms shall not feed on you. Because you are in the light. Thou shalt not allow thy Holy One to see corruption. Who is the Holy One? It's you who are waking into the consciousness of Christ. It's you who are waking into your spirituality. You shall not see corruption. This is the word of the Lord. Rather, you shall see pleasures and delights in eternal. Hallelujah. Praise God. This is for those who dwell in the secret place of the Most High God. Nothing. Fear shall not be your portion anymore. Praise God. Fear of death seed. Thou shalt not fear. You shall not be afraid of the terror at night. Said. Isn't that what? Isn't this what the thing that governs this world that we live in? Look left and right. Everywhere you go, that thing which governs this world is fear. Fear rules in this world. But that shall not be the portion of those who enter into Christ consciousness, because they realize their oneness with the omnipotent one. They awaken to the reality that all power in heaven and earth is mine. All things become plain and clear, and you begin to realize that I live forever. Hallelujah. No one can take my life. This is Christ consciousness. This is pure spiritual consciousness. Hallelujah. This is our calling today, to awaken and enter back into this place. Hallelujah. That we were in from the beginning of the world. Oh, hallelujah. The secret place of the Most High, underneath the wings, the shadows of the cherubim. Nothing shall touch you. Nothing. Praise God. We go down further. We are reading Psalm 91, verse 13. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder. The young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample underneath thy feet. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him and I will set him on high. Because he knoweth my name. He will call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble and I will deliver him and honor him. I will, you know, satisfy him with long life, will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. Praise God. Thou shalt what? Tread underneath your feet. The lion, the adder, the young lion, the dragon. All these are one thing. He's simply talking about the devil. Underneath your feet. You remember in the book of Genesis chapter 3, I think. It says that the seed of the woman shall bruise the head of the serpent. Now the seed of the woman is Christ. See, the seed of the woman is the spiritual, consciousness of Christ. That is the spiritual man. That is Christ within every man. And he bruises the head of the serpent. Now, the serpent is the carnal mind. The serpent is that's the spirit of this world that works with the carnal mind. And better believe it, that carnal mind is the thing that has been a barrier between man and God. That carnal mind is the thing that has robbed man of his power and of his glory. That carnal mind is the thing that has weakened man, blinded man, and caused man to wallow in the dust. See, but those who are beginning to hear truth, those who are beginning to sense truth in this hour, and begin to awake the Christ within them, those who begin to enter back into Christ consciousness, will be the ones to put underneath their feet the serpent, the dragon, the lion, the roaring lion, the accuser of the brethren. See, he accuses you day and night before God. And when he accuses you, he weakens you. You have no more faith to approach God. You have no more faith and you lose your alpha power. You lose the authority. You lose your inheritance in light simply because there is that one, that lion roaring, seeking to destroy, seeking to distract you, seeking to deceive you, seeking to weaken you. But thank God today we have the revelation of Christ telling his sons to awake from the dead. Awake from the dead and begin to recognize your righteousness. Begin to recognize your perfection in the eyes of God. Because God has given us the provision, He has given us the blood of Jesus. Praise God, you don't need to ever walk guilty anymore. Praise God, because Christ in God reconciling the world unto Himself. See, not minding their trespasses. God is not aware of your trespasses. He's not. He doesn't look at your trespasses. He's not aware of those things. It's simply your mind that tells you that you are unrighteous or unworthy before God. God is not aware of any unworthy son. Every man should awake to the reality of his oneness with God. God never left any man. God never told you that you are naked. God never, you know, saw you as a sinner. All this was just the lie of the devil. The lie of what? Of the devil. That is the dragon. See, it works in your mind. It works in the systems of this world. It works in the minds of all men that are ignorant of this truth. This is the realm of accusation. See, it's a realm, this realm of that men live in is a realm of accusation. It's a realm of all manner of evil. Praise God. It's a realm of lusts, of bitterness, of hate, of murderers and all that. But God today, first of all, gives you the victory over your serpent. The serpent in you is your carnal mind. See, it's the mind that attaches you to a natural earthly identity and subtly corrupts you and separates you from God. See, God will give you the victory by allowing you, the Christ in you, to tread upon the serpent. And what peace you will realize, what victory you will realize when you discover that nobody's accusing you. When you discover that nobody's out there, you know, scrutinizing you, you discover that you are perfect as He is perfect. You discover that you are a light creature as He is a light creature. You discover that you have unhindered access to God the Father. Oh, praise God. You know, the adulterous woman, when she was caught in the act, adultery, and of course the accusers went to work. They brought her before Jesus and they were accusing her, telling Jesus that they caught her in the act of adultery. You see, and Jesus stooped down to write on the ground. You see it, and while he was writing on the ground, the crowd, those who were accusing the lady, all disappeared. By the time Jesus Christ rose from the ground, he discovered that he was alone with the lady that was accused by those accusers. And Jesus Christ asked her, "Where are your accusers?" And she said, "They are gone." Jesus Christ told her, "Neither do I accuse you." Now you can imagine the peace that would have come upon the woman at that moment. You can imagine the joy that would have come upon the woman at that moment. You would have imagined the faith that would have come upon that woman at that moment with these comforting words of Jesus. Hallelujah. The Lord is writing the laws in our hearts today by the finger of the Spirit, praise God. And I tell you, if you allow the Lord to finish this work in you, you will discover that there is no accuser anywhere. There is no devil anywhere, no dragon anywhere. All these things are being bound and cast into the bottomless pit where they have no more hold over you. Hallelujah. In the book of Revelations, I think chapter 20, the Bible records, see, the dragon, this same dragon, this same serpent, see, this same devil, Satan, was bound with a big chain by a messenger of God from heaven and cast into what? A bottomless pit and sealed there. And after all this, John saw those who were beheaded for the testimony of Christ, ruling and reigning with Christ. Because why? Because these ones have overcome the lie of the devil. These are the ones who have Satan underneath their feet. God gives you the victory over the beast, over his mark, hallelujah, over his influence in your life. Every accusing influence that men have accused with, every accusing influence that you hear in your ear, your mind, everything is destroyed as you begin to enter into Christ consciousness. Allow the Spirit of God lead you into Christ consciousness. Allow the Spirit of God raise you up. Praise God. Hallelujah. 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 Underneath your feet. So it meaning that you shall have no more power over you. You have the victory over you. This was a sign of Moses. Moses had a victory over the serpent. See it. Jesus Christ said that this sign shall follow those who have believed. They shall pick up serpents with their hands. See it. It talks about the overcoming power that you have through the faith that is in the name of the Lord. It's the victory over the devil. The victory over the accuser that has weakened you over these years. Hallelujah. These are those who enter into Christ consciousness. Recognize Christ as your life. Recognize your true celestial self. See, put on the mind of Christ, the spiritual mind of Christ. See it, let go of carnality. See it, don't identify yourself anymore. See, with carnality, when you identify yourself with carnality, you identify yourself with the devil, with the serpent. Hallelujah, let's move on. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore will I what? Will I deliver him? I will set him high on high, because he has known my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble and I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. You see it? Because what? He has known my name. Because he has what? He has known my name. I will deliver him. He has set his love upon me and he has known my name. I will deliver him and set him on high. Oh, praise God. Hallelujah. I will set him on. Where is he setting you on high? Where? Upon the pinnacle of Zion. Where God has commanded blessings forevermore. Praise God. Upon the pinnacle of Zion. Where God's unlimited blessings rest. Upon the pinnacle of Zion, God's holy mountain, the place of the blessing. Because he has known my name. Hallelujah. How do we know his name? You don't know his name by the letters. You must first of all know the secret of yourself. You must first of all know who you are to know him. Because if you know who you are, you will know that you are him. Paul says that I may know him. See, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. That I may know him and the power of what? Of his resurrection. Hallelujah. See, the resurrection. When you begin to awake in the resurrection, you begin to know yourself the way you are known of God. See, if you do not know him, you are asleep. See, knowing him is knowing Christ. See, and I tell you, you're not going to know any Christ outside of you, but the Christ in you, which is Jesus in you, the Christ in you, the Son of God in you, the immortal one in you, the image of God in you. Because you have known, because he has known me, that I may know him. Hallelujah. Praise God. When Jesus Christ prayed in the book of John, he says that the world has not known me, or the world has not known you, but these ones, he spoke of the disciples that they have known him. See it. God wants every man to know Christ. He wants every man to see Christ. Because this is the eternal life. Eternal life is to know Christ and God. And you cannot know Christ, you can't know God except you know Christ. Because I am the way to the Father. No one cometh to the Father except by me. You must awake to Christ in you. You must awake to your spirituality. You must put on Christ consciousness. That's why Paul says, put on Christ. Put on Christ. Be clothed with Christ. That's your spiritual consciousness. Put on Christ. By faith, you first of all see and recognize. See, you must first of all, every man must first of all pause and see this image. Every man must pause in meditation and see the revelation of Christ. That image is glittering. That light image, immaterial image, glittering upon God's holy hill. Every man must see it and patiently allow the Spirit, lead him back into that state. That is the transformation that occurs in the mind. See, there has to be allowing the word transform us gradually. Praise God. Some people might take them 2 years, 3 years. Some people might take them 20 years, 30 years, 40 years. But the most important thing is to progress. Don't let anything draw you back. Because this is the only thing that matters. What you are hearing today is the only thing that matters. This is the only thing that can give a man salvation. The only way by which a man can be saved is through Christ. The only way by a man can be saved is to recognize the mystery of himself. Recognize his origin in lights. And awake into this great mystery. See it. Those who enter into the secret place of the Most High are those who walk purely spirit, spiritual consciousness. Spiritual consciousness is immaculate. It's pure. See, it is not affected by the corruption that is in this world, the lusts. Isn't it lusts that reign in this world? Lusts. See, the lusts lead to murders. It leads to all kinds of things. The sticky nature of man that attaches him to lowly, beggarly, material things. And you know, we are all created in the image of God. See, we are co-creators with God. We are one with the Father. See, but we descended into becoming the creature. We married ourselves to mortality. But the hours come when those who are in their graves hear the voice of the Son of Man and they are awake back into Christ consciousness. Awaking back into Christ consciousness is the peace and security. See, it's the thing that will make a man walk upon the rocky waves. See, it's the thing that will cause the garden to blossom again. Hallelujah. It is the thing that will cause a man to have the victory over death. Christ consciousness. Those that dwell in the secret place of the Most High. Because you have known the Christ in me. Because you have known my name. Hallelujah. We are admonished to let go of all. Let go of the earthly to hold, take a hold of the heavenly. Praise God. Let go of all. He says, those that dwell, it's not a matter of just entering there, but dwelling. See, we have to come to the place where we are fixed to dwell there. Not just, in and out, but to dwell there. Not into the out tomorrow, but to dwell there. Let the power of God sustain us. Let the grace of God keep us. This is the thing that we are called to in this hour. Recognize the secret place of Christ, of the Most High. It is consciousness. See it. It is awakening to Christ in you. This is the consciousness that nothing can ever separate. Nothing can ever destroy. It remains from eternity to eternity. See, those who walked in that realm 2,000 years ago are still there today, immovable. They are still there the way they were 2,000 years ago. Paul is still the way he was 2,000 years ago. Because he dwells in the secret place of the Most High God. This is our calling. to enter in under the shadow of the Almighty God, dwell in the secret place of God. God bless you.